Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to give you advice on how to do proper beats from 2 feet landing on 2 feet. So I'm going to talk about a royale, I'm going to talk about a entrechat, and I'm going to talk about a entrechat. So I'm going to cover those three jumps with you today. Now, why is an entrechat called a entrechat? Because you're not changing your feet 4 times. So I'll tell you why it's called a entrechat. So if you start in your 5th position, the first thing you have to do is go to a 2nd position in the air. From there, you close behind. From there, you go back into a 2nd, and then you close front. So if I now put, for every movement, if I add a count, this would be count 1, count 2, count 3, count 4. And that is why it's called the entrechat. So it's basically telling you the movements that you have to go through, and that's where the name comes from. Now I started with entrechat because a royale obviously doesn't have any numbers in it. But I would call it an entrechat. Now entrechat does exist in the ballet vocabulary, and that's when you do a royale finishing in a coup de pied. So forget about the coup de pied and think about it being called an entrechat, because what you have to do is you want to cross your legs front, then go into 2nd position, and then close back. That's the original entrechat. I'll show you that one more time. From 5th position, it's crossing, then to 2nd, and then closing it behind. Now, these days, we have changed the way we teach a royale, and it also passes through 4 movements, because these days we want to see the opening before the crossing front, before we open again and then change it back. And I think that might be why in the English ballet vocabulary they have changed the name to royale, because we want to see that opening before we beat front and then beat back. So I hope that makes sense. And then for the entrechat, as you can hear, oh, there's a 6 in there, exactly, because there's 6 movements to go through. Open 1, close 2, open 3, close 4, open 5, close 6. And there you have your 3 beats, but as we have to go through 2nds, it becomes 6 movements, hence the name entrechat. Now, to beat, you need to have a lot of time in the air to be able to put those beats in place. So to get more air time, you want to jump that little bit higher when you are jumping. So you do have that enough and sufficient air time to put those beats in. Now I'm going to start with a entrechat, because I think that's the most well-known petit à l'école step, and I think that would be a good starting point for us. So we've already established that we need to go through 4 movements. So if I'm starting with my right leg front, so I will also need to finish with my right leg in front. So I'm going to open in 2nd, beat back, open in 2nd, and close in front. Now, some students struggle with this step only because they are already touching the floor before they have completed the step, which is a very common thing. So I want you to think about your entrechat, and I want you to think about your air time, so your takeoff, your highest point in the jump, and then you're descending down back to the floor. Now, when you're going up into the air, so this is not your highest point yet, but when you are going up, you already want to go through 2nd and do your 1st beat. At the height of your jump, you want to go back to 2nd, and then on the descent, you want to close in front in 5th position. So I'll say that one more time. You want to start going through 2nd on the way up and beat, and at the highest point, go open, and on your descent, you want to do your last beat. Now, I'll show you one of those. So I'll just do entrechat, and 2nd back to 2nd. Let's see. So I did my first opening really quick, I beat it quick, I open again, and then I close, and I have enough air time. Now, if you don't start your beating action soon enough, no matter how high you are jumping, I'll try and show you one of those now. So I'm still going to jump really high, but I'm going to wait for my beating action. Yes, Well, it wasn't too bad. I was trying to do it worse. But as you can see, I had a lot of air time just being in second. And then I had to really rush the beats on the way down. So you can make it easier by doing that first beat on the way up and then the rest of the beats at the top of your jump and on the way down. Especially if you're going into multiple beats, like a entrechat six, you really want to get that first beat out of the way so you have lots of air time for the next two beats. Now I hope that was clear. Now if I turn to profile, what happens a lot, and I'm sure you've seen this in other students or your teacher has mentioned it, is that we start going parallel. Now, a lot of people don't really understand how to get rid of that issue. Now, what happens when you go in parallel is basically you're not doing the second position. If you're not doing the second position, if I just think about beating, I will also go straight back instead of opening my legs to the sides. So I'll show you that one more time. If I'm just thinking about beating and I do entrechat, I'm going in parallel a little bit. Yes? So what you want to do is go to the side and then cross back, side and then cross front. If you do your first side and you do your first beat, that rebound will push you back into second. So it's really that first opening to second position that is crucial. So now let's talk about a royale. So we've already established that a royale or an entrechat trois without the coup de pied started initially by from the fifth position crossing over, going to second, and then beating back. Yes? Now, these days we open first, then cross front, then open again, and then we close back. So it's almost an entrechat quatre because it does have four movements that we have to go through. However, it's not called an entrechat quatre. So, same thing, I'm going to start on my right leg. I need to open to second, then cross front, open to second, and then cross behind. Yes, and as you're seeing this video, you'll see that I'm overcrossing quite a lot. And the reason that I do that is because I was trained to beat with my inner thighs. And that is really the way you want to beat. You don't want to think about your feet crossing. You want to think about your upper legs crossing over. Because then you're really using your adductors and your inner thighs for that nice beating action. But also, the beat will be clear. If you beat with your feet, you don't always cross enough. And then you don't even see the beat. So remember, cross with the upper part of your legs, and that's why I'm really overcrossing my legs, in case you were thinking, sitting at home, well, why is he doing that? That's what I'm doing. Okay, so back to the royale. So cross front first, and then back. Now, in all these beats, what would be lovely is to hit the last fifth position before you hit the floor. So I'll show you the changement, so just a simple change of feet. What I don't want to see is a jump and my legs coming together as I land. What I would like to see is a fifth and then land. So you want to squeeze your legs together and then keep maintaining that squeeze before you land. And it's the same in a royale. I'll show you a royale now. I'm going to have my arms out because I'll be able to show the beats a little bit clearer if my arms are out. So excuse my arms. So I'm going to do royale, and really look out for that fifth position at the end. So front back, and then. I'll do that one more time. I'll jump a little bit higher, and front back, and then. Yes, you can see that fifth position before I hit the floor, and you want to do that in all your beats. Now I'm going to move on to entrechat six. Yes, so you want to change three times. Now my tip for you today, because if you're on the floor and you think, oh my gosh, there's so much stuff I have to do in the year, then you already start panicking before you've even started the step. So I say, break it down, and for me as a dancer, that really worked. Because an entrechat six was not my favorite step. I was always freaking out that I would, you know, fall over my own feet. It just wasn't my step. So I broke it down for myself, and it really worked for me. And it seems to be working for all my students. So my tip for you today is to think of doing an entrechat quatre with a changement at the end. And what that does is, what I also need to do is to think about doing your entrechat quatre on the way up and the chauchement on the way down. So there's two things. First thing is break it down. Do entrechat quatre first and then change. And the second thing is to do the entrechat quatre on the way up and the chauchement on the way down. Because what that will do is it will really force you to get those first few beats out of the way. So you're really utilizing all that airspace that you have. But also, it will make it a little bit simpler for you in your head, and you will you'll be able to think clearer about where the feet have to go. Now, because there's so many beats, you want to think about going through first position, not second position. Because if you go too wide with the legs, you're going to be losing air time by going into second. So go into first position, first back, first front, first back. So still going sides, but not too wide. So really my tip for you today is to get that first beat out of the way so you can utilize the rest of your air space for the following beats. So a good exercise is to really train how to do that first, second, and that first beat. And that's all I want you to do. I want you to, you can start with two hands at the bar, or you can just do it in the center. So any leg in front, you're just gonna go into second and beat on your way up, and then hold the fifth as you come down. Yes, so again, I'm gonna have my arms to the side. So second, fifth, and down. I'll try and demonstrate it. And second, fifth, down. And then one on the other leg. And second, fifth, down. So I'm really trying to do that on the way up, and I'm trying to go out and in as fast as I can. And that's really I mean, I can really feel that in my upper legs, and that's exactly what you want to do. Now, you can do this over and over, and you know, it would be good to do this every day, you know, after your TLA grow section, when you're nice and warm, just add a few of those in your daily class, and I'm sure your beats will get a lot better. Now, that's the first part of the beats. When they're nice and strong, then you can add on the multiple beats after that. But try and practice that at home, and let me know how you get on, because it is a very good exercise. Now, another good exercise, and I'll show that to you holding the bar, ideally you'll be facing the bar, I'll just hold the bar behind me, is you want to train the inner thighs to overcross. So a good exercise, I'm sure you've done it, is when a flexed foot on your gestring leg, is to just cross and fifth. And you have to make sure that you are going into second position, because that's what we want in the beats. And you really want to cross. And now what I'm trying to do, I'm now going to overcross, is I'm really squeezing my adductors together. And you can do that as fast as you can. Yeah. And here in this exercise, in a normal ballet class setting, you'd want your body to stay nice and still, and you don't want to sink in your hip, all of the usual corrections. However, if you're really training your upper thighs, you can almost slightly forget about that. And just if you do this for, I don't know, a good 2-3 minutes, I mean, you're really going to start fatiguing those upper thighs. And that's really when you're working those muscles. It's only when they get fatigued that they're going to get stronger. So if you just do 8 of them, it's like doing nothing. Yeah, so really try and get to that point where you get really tired, and then you're really training your legs. So let's summarize that all up for you. So I briefly spoke about a royale, a entrechat quatre, and an entrechat six. I've explained to you why they are called those steps in the French terminology. So now you should clearly understand why there's a number 4 in there, or why there's a number 6 over there. Now, what I want you to think about first is to go to second position. Yeah, that's the first part of your beats, of all beats, go to second position. What will that do? It will make sure that you're not going parallel in your beats. Yeah, so that's the first thing you should do. Now, I want you to train and do the exercise I've just showed you, is to break it down, go second, fifth, and then land. Second, fifth, and then land. And you can do that over and over again, and that's really to train that, getting that first beat out of the way, so you have lots of air space for your other beats coming after that. Now, I also told you that you should try and do your first beat on your way up after takeoff, then do whatever, how many beats you want at the top of the height, and you can still do beats on the way down. But really that first beat you should do on the way up so that you're not losing any air time. And then lastly, you want to try and think about overcrossing with the top of the legs so that you really sing those beats nice and clearly from a distance. And you want to finish in a fifth position before you hit the floor. That's a very difficult point. Sorry, I couldn't get my words out. That's a difficult point. Yeah, if you're really strong in beats, that's something that you would think about, is to keep it in fifth before you land, so that you don't close your legs as you're landing. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this tip. Please practice your beats and apply my tips and exercises, and come back to me and let me know how you're getting on, because that would make me really happy. And don't forget to subscribe, and see you next time. Bye bye.